we're rewriting our Lake Park case. We have a new person with us tonight, and I have her name here. And it is Ms. Hilton. Would you like to present the case tonight, ma'am?
Yes, sir. I'm Loretta Hilton from the Southern Georgia Regional Commission. This is for application number LP-2017-08-04. The petition by Leona Register to change the zoning of a 1.687 acre parcel located at Highway 41 and 4-H Club Road in the Incorporated Lake Park, and being more specifically described as map number 199 parcel 212 from R10 single family residential to CC community commercial. Staff recommends approval of the application of Ms. Register to change the zoning of the 1.687 acre parcel from R10 single family residential to CC community commercial. We felt that this was a change in area with a commercial across from it, and it being community commercial, that would only be commercial that would benefit the area, and staff recommends approval of this request.
Okay. Any questions from the commissioner to Ms. Hilton?
I have one.
Very good, go ahead.
Ms. Hilton, do you know what they want to change this zoning bar, what they want to put there?
No, sir. All they told us is that they haven't been able to sell it in the past, and that they just want to rezone it to be able to get rid of the property.
So they don't have any concrete plans?
No, sir. Not to my knowledge.
Okay.
Anyone else have any questions?
Yes, I may. It seems that we discussed this briefly at the work session last week, but it seems like that parcel was taken out from a bigger, much bigger parcel, sometimes along its history. Do we have any history on that? At what point it was annexed into the city?
I don't have any history on that. No, okay. No, it's been a while ago.
Any other questions from the commission? Yeah, we'll now open it up to the people, for the people to speak that are in favor of this request. Anyone is willing to speak in favor of this request, please state your name and address when you get to the podium, sir.
Good evening. My name is Henry.
Yes, sir.
Nathan Smith. Address 3890 Island Creek Road, by Austin, Georgia, 31601. I'm here with the Herndon Company. I'm a realtor with the Herndon Company, representing the owner of the property, the registrar. Here lately, just to try to answer some more questions on the 1.68 acres. It's part of a bigger parcel that had come up later that we're trying to rezone community commercial, about 15 acres on that corner. This just happens to be in the city of Lake Park. The history, to kind of answer your question, the father cut that out for the post office. They was looking for a new location. So that's what he did, and then they decided to go on 376 down there. That's what I kind of understand. The reason it was cut out is put into the city. So it just kind of sticks out in that corner of the city, probably with everything else being counted. And we have had a contract in the past on that corner for a relocation of, right across the street is community commercial, the Dollar General, Badcock, and another business where Lake Jerry Corbett opened up the moving place a long time ago, is still in the fork in the road. That's all zoned community commercial, so we're just trying to get the same zoning they have across the street. The Dollar General, which was going to build a bigger one, they pulled their contract, just waited for a later date and renewed a lease across the street for a few years, but they still want to have a bigger place in Lake Park. But that's a little bit of the history of that corner. Just want to answer the question.
Any questions from the commission?
Nathan, across the street there's several parcels that are CC. Can you tell me what the uses of those? It looks like four parcels.
Yes, well, the Badcock actually is a furniture store, and the Dollar General is a dollar store. Both of them have been there for years. And the parcel now, I don't know if it's like a boutique or heavy. I mean, originally it was a movie place where they sold movies before, that kind of went out, but all that, you know, it's CC.
Sounds like I wasn't listening to you.
Yeah, and it is, I mean, the reason that track is more, you know, I guess desirable is because they have the cut in the road right there over 41, and you know, and we're not trying to rezone anything on the other side. You know, they have a lot of frontage on 41 up against the school, but we're not trying to rezone that to be a commercial.
Any other questions from the presenter?
So at this point, it's just purely speculative. There's no contracts or anything on the table for anybody to come in.
That's correct. The price that is on it is a commercial price. It's naturally, anybody that buys it, you know, if the neighborhood store wanted to come in or anybody, it would have to be part of the rezoning process. So they're just trying, the owners are trying to put it in a better position to sell, because that's the highest and best use of that particular property.
Okay, any other questions? Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Anyone wishing to speak in favor of this request? Anyone wishing to speak in favor of this request? Hearing none, we'll move on to the people that were wanting to speak against this request. Please come forward, state your name and address for the record, sir.
I'm Wesley Luke. 2014 Club Road, right on the corner, directly across from this parcel. And I will be affected the most if something goes in there. And I want it to stay where a single family can live over there. If you go to this here blinded, like this, not know what it could be, and it don't become a Dollar General, it could be a curb store. They could be brothels out there at 10 or 12 every night, and I got a front bedroom that with a bunch of windows in it, the bullets that come right through it, had a robbery. My granddaughters or down at my house every weekend. I don't want to take that kind of chance of taking this away from getting residential. I know what he just said about Dollar General going in and getting everyone getting your $200,000. That piece of land is commercial. It's not worth near that. That's the reason it's worth the commercial. He just, like Nathan just said, it's more bank than it's commercial. But we're in a residential neighborhood. I won't take a lot of time. A lot of people want to speak. But that's what I've got to say. I hope, pray to people. Growing my neighborhood, I've been there 20 years in my life. And we won't want to change
the
business. There's nothing across the street from
there.
Thanks.
Is there any questions for Mr. Wilson?
Go ahead. Mr. Lee, I think it would be to the east of you, if I'm getting my direction right. It looks to be, is there a vacant lot? Is the second lot off of 41? Or off of West Mary? Is that a vacant lot?
I'm on the corner of West Mary and Ann.
What's the next lot down 4X Club Road?
It belongs to.
It's not your.
This Gallagher. No. And then the next one belongs to Dawson Vick.
Okay.
And that, it does go commercial as far down as his house, what they're trying to resolve.
Okay.
It would take it's a long stretch where that one is stretched out. Anyone else?
Any other questions for Mr. Moon? Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thanks for listening.
Yes, sir. Anyone else like to speak? Name and address for the record, please.
My name is Dawson Vick. 204 Fort Slow Road. I live one block down.
Your name was what again, sir?
Dawson
Vick.
Yes, sir. I'm totally against this. I was doing some research. According to the Adams County Unified Land Development Code, you can put outdoor markets, banks, gas stations, grocery stores, vending machines, self-service laundry, offices, mini stores, parking lots, agricultural businesses, commercial business, kennels, alcohol sales, which would be a package store, animal hospital, trucking auto repair. If you've ever seen a trucking auto repair, you know about the junk that's going to be around you. Daycare centers and a car wash. Just some of the things that is permitted under this rule. That I don't believe we need on the corner of Marion Street and Boys Club Road. I've been there since 83 and I bought the first lot and built the first house there. I've noticed throughout the years that our kids, when my kids grew up, they went up and down Boys Club Road, they rode their bicycles, they walked the dog, we have runners out there exercising up and down that road all the time. I saw a family, a typical family, man, his wife, his son, his daughter on bicycles, and his son was pulling a wagon with his dog in it, up and down Forest Road. That would all go away if you put this commercial in there with all that traffic coming in. That would be gone. I just want to say that to you, and I thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Mr. Baker. Anyone else want to, or excuse me, was there any questions from staff? I'm sorry, I'm just temporary here. Anyone else to speak in, against this request? Please come forward, ma'am, with your name and address.
My name is Mindy Rutherton. I live at 424 H. Pub Road. I'm down the street a little bit further down, but I'm one of the people that run and walk on the street on 4 H. Pub Road. We have become a golf cart community where we are close-knit and we're in a great neighborhood. It is very difficult already to deal with the traffic that comes up and down that road trying to cut through the Long Pond Road. And if you put in this commercial business, you're going to make it even worse for all the people who actually live there and enjoy being out in the country, which is one of the reasons we chose to live there, where there aren't all the businesses. There are businesses further down the street, but in this neighborhood, we are just a neighborhood full of loving people, and we need to keep it that way. Thank you.
Any questions for the requester? Okay. Do we have time for one more, Jason?
Yes, sir.
Anyone else liking to speak against this request? Please come forward. Come on, ma'am.
My name is Linda Ray. I live at 603 4-H Club Road. We have been there for over 4 years. It is a very nice neighborhood. Coming out from 4-H Club Road, it's Marion or 41. Right before you get to 4-H Club Road, there is a curb. We see cars flying around that curb all the time. If they develop something of a commercial nature, I could just see a lot of accidents waiting to happen. I consider that also safety reasons why I am against this.
Any questions for the presenter?
Thank you.
Four more minutes. Anyone wanting to speak against this request, please come forward. Your name, sir, for the
record? My name is Barry Plotnick. I live at 411 Jackson Circle. I was going to save my speech for later on in one of the other properties, but I'll just mention that I live about a block away from this property, maybe two blocks away, and we're already mired in controversy with, we're in litigation, 75 of us homeowners in the city of Lake Park against the I'm sure some of you are familiar with it regarding the ownership of the bottom of the lake. I live on one of the highest tax waterfront properties in the state of Georgia. And to listen to this guy with all the different businesses that go in there, repair shops, whatever he was mentioned, we don't have to, I have a very expensive home. I plan on talking more further about the other tract of land, but as you can see, we the people are totally against all of this.
Very well. Any questions for the presenter? Come ahead, sir.
I have only lived there.
Your name, sir?
My name is Blake Ellis. I live at 805 Teresa Drive.
Go ahead, sir.
I have lived there for over 50 years. He does not have the highest taxes. I do. There is all kinds of available commercial land in this area that anything could be of a commercial nature could be put on. We're asked to buy a pig and a boat. We don't know what's going on in this land. And apparently they don't have to tell us. Is that true?
There's no plans required, right? Excuse me, Ms. Cope.
No.
So until we see some sort of master plan of some type as to what they're planning to do with this land, if we rezone it, I don't see that it's appropriate for us to rezone it and not know any more about it than we know about it.
Any questions for Mr. Ellis? Thank you very much. All right, we will close the public participation at this time. Thank you all. And I will turn it over to the commission for any questions that they have for Ms. Hill.
I actually have a question for staff. And this question would also be applicable to the next case we're going to be hearing later on, which is the rest of this property that happens to be within bounds. So the future development map shows this area as a suburban area. Is that correct? What color is suburban area shown here? So in suburban area, what are permissible uses in the current zone
that allow for community
work? Allows for community work. What, so with the, if I could have a follow-up question, what is the required buffer between community commercial and the properties across the street, across 4-H Club, which are R10? They are R10 property, right?
Yes, I'd have to research that more. That I could have had it for you just now.
Is that it?
Well, I think that's it as far as my question. I do have a comment that's more, I guess, a discussion, but I think it would be wise for us as a commission to look at this property, not just at this case, not just independently, especially that we know we've already looked at the rest of this case, which happens to be in the rest of in Miles County. I think that needs to be looked at holistically. I understand one of the properties in Lake Park, the other one is in Vance County, but I think it would be, we need to keep in mind that these are connected. There ought to be some sort of a holistic approach to looking at both of these cases.
While she's looking that up, we have any other questions or comments?
We should take that portion of the video.
Well, I mean, and this is some of the comments. Again, I'm sort of, so that when this case came up last week during the work session, the first reaction that I had, not knowing that the following, that there was going to be another case of what, this looked a little bit odd, that it's being cut out, and what is the plan for that? Then when we saw the next case, we realized, well, there's a bigger approach going on here that I personally, I agree with what Mr. Ellis was saying there. The county case is a very large property. It's the size of, could be the size of a town. And so without an overall look to see how is this going to impact the surrounding areas, there are already established neighborhoods across the street. I think it's, you know, the word appropriate. It's not appropriate really to look at 140 acres or however big that property is without really knowing what sort of plans are going to happen there. And so by jumping from R1 to CC, although CC is allowed in suburban area, I think there ought to be some better vision. There ought to be a clearer vision of how this is actually going to be planned and how it's going to be impacting the lake park. This is going to be a large chunk of that area.
Listen, I agree. I think that the two cases probably should have been looked at together. I know there are separate cases, mm-hmm. but it really is one piece of property.
And we did communicate staff-wise, Ms. Loretta and I, early on to make sure that we were on the same page to try to coordinate that. But with it being under two different jurisdictions, there was only so much we could do. Mm-hmm. But we did, early on, we communicated actually quite a bit to try to make sure that our recommendations and our analysis was on the same page.
Is it possible then for us to hear discussions on both cases before we vote?
I've never seen it done that way, but to me, I understand the value of taking the other public hearing and then deciding on the motions at the end. It's just a very unique procedural thing, but it is where we are because for some reason they chose to annex this piece of property into the city while leaving the balance in the county.
Just food for thought. You know, there is a distinct difference between the Lowndes County property and this property in that this small piece of property fronts on a four-lane U.S. highway, and the remainder of the property is more, in my mind, of a non-commercial nature. So I can see, at least in my opinion, I can see different outcomes for these two pieces of property. So I don't, just in my opinion, I don't think we necessarily need to consider these together. We have the knowledge of what both of them are at this point, so.
I think according to the state law, you can have a discussion probably to that until it's actually up for public hearing. You have to, the next item would have to be, the county would have to be in discussion for public hearing to be able to comment on it.
Well, I think we can proceed with the Snake Park case with the understanding that, I mean, we know, everybody knows in here that there's actually two cases and they're connected there by the same property owner. So we know that. And if we need to be separating public hearing portions of that, I mean, we understand we need to do that and we ought to stick to that. But Brad, I think the rest of the property, a large portion of it does sit along Marion Avenue. It's a big frontage of it actually is commercial. And I'm not debating the fact whether commercial is appropriate or not. I actually think I just would like to see a vision for this. This is it's a significant piece of property. I gave an example last week that the land of the property is it's as big as two seasides or to one and a half, you can fit pound and a half in there. And so I can understand the corner piece, the corner property, which is the one in Lake Park, that part of it is along Marion Avenue. I can understand that having some commercial quality to it just because of its location. But I also understand it's going to impact the neighborhood across the street. So if that zoning is going to happen, we ought to consider conditions like, for example, shielding lights that might spill from any exterior lighting as well as vehicular in and out coming into that property, that light need to be shielded for the properties across the street. So these are the things we have to discuss. It's important to see it holistically, but I also can understand the significance of that, the corner lot with the commercial potential, especially given that across the street and there's already community commercial, that's already commercial CH use across Marion Avenue.
Any other questions or comments?
I did have the information on the buffer. It says the buffer yard shall be located on the side and rear of the lot or parcel and extend inward from the parcel boundary line for the required depth. Buffer yard shall not be located in any portion of an existing or dedicated public right-of-way or private street or stormwater detention or retention area. Buffer yard shall not be used for any parking or loading purposes nor contain structures. Only approved driveways and pedestrian pathways may be encroached into a required buffer yard.
So will the buffer be required between CC and the residential area that happens to be across the street or not? I couldn't get that from the description.
It is required between the commercial and single family.
Yeah. Any other comments?
I don't think that's going to be the case when separated by street.
That's what I am.
I think what you're saying, Selena, I guess I tend to maybe agree with you, is it's not, this is necessarily a bad application in all that respect, but it may be premature.
Like what you just heard is put that front yards are required along the side and rear yards, not the front yards, not the street yards. And that's typical in most jurisdictions, so there would be no buffer yard required along the street.
Any other comments? Okay, commissioners, turn it over for a vote. Anyone?
I make a motion at this time that we deny the request.
We have a motion to deny the request. Do we have any seconds?
I'll second that.
Okay. We have a motion and a second. And everyone that is in favor, please raise your right hand of denial. Everyone that's in favor of denial, please raise your right hand. Okay, well that's four, so I've got to go to the everyone that's in favor of approval of this request. Please raise your right hand. Everyone in favor?
No.
Whoever's opposed to the motion.
Sir?
Whoever's opposed to the motion.
Oh. Whoever's opposed to the motion. Excuse me. I'd like to raise right hands of everyone that's opposed to the motion. We have one. So the motion has been passed. Yes, for denial. Correct?
Correct. Missed that.
Mr. Chairman, I think you're missing two of your voters.
Well, I can't vote, so.
There are seven of you voting.
Yeah.
Four plus one is five.
And does anybody have any, what do we do in that situation?
Mr.
Gentleman reached showing another hand.
I made a motion.
The gentleman who made the motion did not vote.
Oh, okay.
How many do we have in favor of?
Yeah, how many do we have in favor of the denial? Please raise your right hand. No, it's five. Okay. All opposed to the motion? We have two. 5-2, Ms. Carmella? All right, now, I think that's it, and so we have recommended denial of the motion.
Mr. Ball and Mr. McClendon.
Okay, let's move on to the next case, Jason.
Yes, sir.